The long-awaited Dashcam and Sentry Mode Viewer is here. Finally. Up until this point, in order to view the footage stored on your USB drive, you had to give the Dashcam icon a long press to unmount the USB drive, and then plug it into your computer and click through a ton of files to try to find the video you're looking for. Now, there were, of course, a few third parties that made this process a lot easier, and one of my favorites, Sentry View from the Stats App Developer, along with a few others that even allowed you to view the footage without taking out the USB drive. Although at the time, they were the best alternatives, but nothing is better than viewing it directly on the center screen, and it's very simple to use. While in park, simply press the dashcam icon. This will pull down a menu. From there, you have two options, save footage or launch viewer. In this case, you want to tap launch viewer. Side note, when you are driving the car, tapping the dashcam icon will not reveal the menu, but instead save a clip like it always has. Once you tap launch viewer, the latest video from the USB drive starts playing video from the front camera. Simultaneously, the rear camera is playing in the upper right, the right camera in the lower right, and the left camera in the lower left. The upper left is reserved for the front camera. Now you can easily change which camera is the main video by tapping any one of the other cameras. You can pause, play, or scroll by using the video controls at the bottom, and they work as you'd expect. And one thing I've noticed though is the scroll does not scrub through the video. Instead, it just advances to where you scroll to. Although not a big deal breaker, scrubbing through the video is easier, so this could be an area of improvement in a future update. Finding the video you're looking for is very easy. Tap the menu screen in the upper left-hand corner, and the videos are organized by date, and in some cases, location, along with a thumbnail. You can also filter to only view dashcam files, Sentry files, or both. It's also very easy to delete a video. Select the video you want to delete, and the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, press the trash can icon. Overall, I'm very pleased with the Dashcam Viewer. As of right now, my only complaint is the lack of scrubbing while scrolling through a video. Although the Dashcam Viewer took the main stage in this update, there were a couple of other things I noticed. Now, Tesla replaced the old Sentry Mode icon with a new one. This is most likely because the original icon is copyright protected by MGM from the movie 2001: A Space Odyssey. Now, the new one is believed to be inspired by the game Portal, developed by Valve. Could this be another copyright violation? I doubt it. But in the end, other than the icon, there are no other changes to how Sentry Mode operates. Another thing I noticed is the Bluetooth communication between my iPhone and the car seems to be a lot better. I've noticed the car senses the phone much sooner than before and unlocks the car. And this may also be something I never noticed before, but it also flashes the lights to let me know the car is unlocked. Now, I know it would do that when you manually unlock it from the app or use the key card, but not when it senses Bluetooth. Again, I could be wrong on that one, but the one thing I do know for sure is the communication with my phone seems a lot better. Overall, this latest update is short but sweet. And although the Dashcam Viewer may seem trivial, it has been requested by most Tesla owners pretty much since Dashcam was released. Now, if you've recently updated to the software, let me know what you think. I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments section below. As usual, like, subscribe, and until recently, stay safe. I'm Frugal Tesla Guy, and until my next video, stay positively charged.